Hey there. If my phone rings one more time while I'm trying to make this video, I swear I'm going to throw it out the window. This week we're talking about LGBT people we may have known during our childhood and the differences in the world between being LGBT then and being LGBT now, and how people were perceived and what they may have gone through. And as a child, I knew several LGBT people because my father was a chef. And for whatever reason, there was a lot of LGBT people working in hotels at that time. And because they weren't doing the 9-to-5 thing that everyone else was doing, they were working irregular hours. They had a lot of get-togethers and did birthdays and all that kind of thing together. It was quite funny because they did it several years after they stopped working together as well, once they'd moved on to work at other hotels and stuff. And while it sounds all inclusive, the big difference, I think, between that point in time and now is that no one talked about it. I don't even know how I knew as a child that these people were gay, because I don't recall anyone ever discussing it in any context, ever. And the defining moment when I remember that changing was we returned to New Zealand when I was about 13 and the AIDS epidemic had hit. And it was a horrible, horrible time. And I'm talking pre-retrovirals, pre the identification of HIV. We didn't know what any of that was. We didn't know how AIDS was communicated. We didn't know any of that. All we knew was that our family friends were dying and there were many, many, many funerals. It was horrible. Not only was it a horrible way to die, it was that anticipation, because perfectly healthy people would suddenly have dramatic weight loss and you knew it was over. Like, they're walking around living, breathing, alive, but you knew it was a matter of time, because it became clear early on that no one survived AIDS. So I'm talking about full-blown AIDS. I'm not talking about HIV. I should also clarify in this conversation that a huge percentage of people in the world don't have access to those retrovirals. So if I make it sound like the cure of all this time is now over, then please forgive me. I'm talking about developed nations mainly. And one of those funerals sticks in my brain in the context of the difference between how it is now and how it was then. It was a very different world. And we had two family friends, Russell and Lucas, and Russell got AIDS. He went downhill very quickly and he passed away. Now, Russell and Lucas had lived together for what seems like forever. I mean, hey, I was a teenager, but they presented to the world as a married couple. I mean, obviously you couldn't get married then, but they lived together. They did everything together. You know, they owned and ran a restaurant together. So we go to Russell's funeral, and there's a lot of LGBT people at Russell's funeral, and Lucas, Russell's partner, is not mentioned once in that funeral. And not only is he not mentioned once, none of the rest of us, I mean, I guess I was very young, but anyone else, no one said anything. And you might think, hey, like, you know, you don't go causing a drama at a funeral, but I think if that was now, someone would stand up and tactfully acknowledge Lucas, or tactfully acknowledge whoever's partner it was, but no one said anything. And what ended up happening was, after the formal ceremony, another person said, hey, you know, there was a small queer bar, and they said, hey, let's, you know, go there, have a proper funeral and awake and say goodbye properly, because this didn't really do it for anyone. So we went there, and I guess all rules were relaxed that evening, because I was not legally old enough, I was 13, to be in a bar, but that was the state of play at the time. And I think even though it was a terrible thing to happen, and oh, it's a horrible I hope we never see anything like that again. But it would trigger a social justice movement that would break the silence that had gone before it. Suddenly, people were coming out of the closet. People were being visible. They were saying, hey, we have to get out there and get some rights or more people are going to die, you know, especially once the information came through and it became apparent how you could pass HIV on and that HIV was the cause of AIDS and all the rest of it. There was a movement that had so much momentum to get money and research behind it. I mean, it's arguably one of the fastest achieving social justice movements the Western world has seen. So it very much changed the landscape for LGBT people, and if nothing else, it certainly broke that silence. And suddenly people were talking about things, you know. Anyway, I don't know how I got into that rave from the family member thing. Maybe I should get going. If you know of any LGBT people during your childhood, it would be really interesting to hear about it. Put it in the comments below. Put anything you like, really. Have a wonderful weekend, and I'll see you next week. Bye for now.